Hi, everybody. It's Lauren Dockett with Psychotherapy Networker. And with me today is Deb Dana. Welcome, Deb.
Thank you.
Deb is the coordinator of the Traumatic Stress Research Consortium at the Kinsey Institute, and she is the author of The Polyvagal Theory in Therapy. She recently wrote an article for us on the healing potential of touch, and that article was informed by polyvagal system. So we're going to talk about touch, Deb, in a second, but first, let's just quickly cover, and I know it's hard to do this quickly, let's quickly cover why therapists and clients might want to familiarize themselves with the polyvagal system.
Okay, let's dive in quick. So the autonomic nervous system is the foundation for our lived experience, and polyvagal theory is a roadmap for understanding the nervous system. So for therapists, understanding how their nervous system is sending cues of danger or safety to their clients every moment that we're working in session feels really important. And then for clients to understand how their nervous system operates and to really become active operators of their own system, to me, is an important part of the therapy process.
Okay. And then, so once they have that understanding of the system, maybe they'll also be a little more accepting of touch. Well, how does touch between a therapist and client affect that system?
So touch is both a regulator and an activator of the autonomic nervous system. So touch can be an incredibly powerful piece of experience to bring in to our work with clients. I talk about, in the article, I think I talk about handshake. I greet my clients with a handshake. I end the session with a handshake. Our hands are very receptive, have a lot of receptors and send a message. And handshakes are fairly commonly accepted practices. So it is a way of bringing touch in. I think really what we want to do with our clients is kind of begin to understand through the nervous system rather than through their cognitive narrative, but learn the autonomic nervous system story of touch. What is their experience of touch through the nervous system? Mm-hmm. And then we can begin to play around with what would be touch that your nervous system would be able to take in right now and would bring you into a ventral experience, into that experience of feeling safe and connected, mm-hmm. and what kind of touch takes you into a sympathetic, mobilized fight, flight, or the dorsal disconnect. Mm-hmm. And that's really where we want to start to really play around with what kind of touch brings what autonomic response.
Okay. And then how do you do that? How do you introduce these various kinds of touch? Is it a verbal introduction? Are you actually putting hands together? You know, what exactly are you doing?
Great. So in my work, we use an autonomic mapping process first to get to know the nervous system and then to understand triggers and what I call glimmers, which are those moments of connection, and then to find resources. And so I use the same mapping process, mm-hmm. with touch. We create a touch map. And we will play around with either actual physical touch, if that is what the nervous system says it can tolerate in order to experiment, or oftentimes we'll first talk about touch, and I have a touch menu, mm-hmm. that we will go over, and we can just listen to what happens in your nervous system when I say, what would it be like for me to put my hand on your back? Mm-hmm. Listen to your nervous system, and then we can imagine it, mm-hmm. and then we can actually enact it if that feels like we're going in the direction of ventral. And clients, I found, are pretty easily able, if we just stay with state and stay out of story, are pretty easily able to identify, oh, at this touch, you know, if you reach out your hand and we just, you know, touch hands this way or touch fingers, and that ET finger to finger often brings a sense of connection in a new way, mm-hmm. in a way the nervous system says, oh, that's interesting. And clients can really pretty easily, just through the nervous system, say, oh, I don't want you to touch my knee, mm-hmm. or I don't want you to touch my shoulder. So, you know, I found that there's a pretty clear autonomic response when we say we're just going to listen to your nervous system and we're not going to listen to story, because story then brings in a different dimension. So we want to listen to, not that we're not listening to story, but we're listening to the nervous system story rather than the brain story.
Okay. And then a final question for you about this. Can clients bring this home? Can they bring it into their life outside of therapy and incorporate touch that they know will take them to a ventral state, I guess is what they're going for mostly?
Yes. Yeah. Absolutely, absolutely. And, you know, I often have clients, I love it when clients say, oh, could I bring my partner or my friend or my child with me? I always say yes. I love it when clients bring people with them and we can play with it in the session. Mm-hmm. And I also encourage them to take this map home and talk to the trusted people in your life and say, here's what I know about my nervous system now. And here are the ways that you could really touch me, that touch my nervous system and really help me come into regulation. And then when that happens, you know, we could help map, you know, your nervous system, and maybe I could help you with the same thing. Mm-hmm. And I have clients that have come back and said, oh yes, I took it to my partner and they were very able to help me. And then I said, and maybe I could help you. And it's created this lovely new autonomic intimacy, I call it, that, mm-hmm. That has really rippled out and had great benefits. Yeah.
Wonderful. Well, thank you, Deb. This is a good introduction to this whole aspect of polyvagal. It's exciting stuff. Appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.